So Michael Gorbachev, who was eventually knighted by the Queen and became a Knight of Lazarus, which is wears the Templar cross, only it's a green cross, that's his function, is to side with Maurice Strong and push the Earth Charter, etc. He wrote a book, or at least he had it written for him. It's called Michael Gorbachev, The Search for a New Beginning, subtitled Developing a New Civilization. And he said, the greening of politics, and that's where the Green Party, you see, it was started in the Soviet bloc, the Green Party. And in fact, it was started up by a right-hand man of Stalin. His daughter or granddaughter took it over and brought it to Europe. The greening of politics is an affirmation of the priority of values common to humanity, enriching education and upbringing with ecological content from childhood onward, and developing a new and modern attitude towards nature. At the same time, the greening of politics is the return to humankind of the awareness of humanity as a part of nature. Now, that rings a bell if you read the Biodiversity Treaty, where you have no more rights than an ant. In fact, they have more rights than you do. The moral improvement of society and the maturation of civilization is inconceivable without this. Michael goes on elsewhere to talk about the choices facing humankind. Today, humankind is facing a choice. It's time for every individual, nation, and state to rethink its place and role in the world affairs. We need an intellectual breakthrough into a new dimension. This is the great leap forward of masonry once again. And that means the state of the human spirit assumes paramount importance. The roles of culture, religion, science, and education must grow enormously. The responsibility of the Centers for Humanity's intellectual, scientific, and religious development is immense and must be given preeminence. And it sure has, because we didn't have any say in the thing at all. The future of human society will not be defined in terms of capitalism versus socialism. It was that dichotomy that caused the division between the world community into two blocks and brought about so many catastrophic consequences. We need to find a paradigm that will integrate all the achievements of of the human mind and human action, irrespective of which ideology or political movement can be credited with them. This is the coming together of the heads and the tails of the coin, because they're both run by the same money men, you see. This paradigm can only be based on the common values that humankind has developed over many centuries. The search for a new paradigm should be a search for synthesis. So you had the thesis, you see, capitalism, the antithesis of communism, and here's the synthesis for what is common to and unites people, countries, and nations, rather than what divides them. The search for such a synthesis can succeed if the following conditions are met. First of all, we must return to the well-known human values that are embodied in the ideals of the world religions, and also in the socialist ideas that inherited much from those values. He means the Fabian society. Further, we need to search for a new paradigm of development that is based on those values and that is capable of leading us towards a generally humanistic, now remember that word, humanistic, or more precisely, humanistic ecological culture of living. So humanism, of course, believes that man is God because there's nothing else, so that the most advanced intellectually have the right to rule over those less advanced. And ecology, of course, is to do with the planet and economy as well, all lumped into one. A scientific socialism is what he's talking about. He's reiterating the very values that Bertrand Russell, H.G. Wells, and all the rest of the Fabian Society were spouting out back in the 1800s, and still do, actually. Their descendants still run the Fabian Society today. And he said, too, here that, this is Gorbachev, the philosophy of the 21st century must be grounded in a philosophy of diversity. Who have heard that before? If life is such as the highest value, then even more precious is the singular identity of every nation and every race as a unique creation of nature and human history. At the same time, we must begin to define certain moral maxims or ethical commandments that constitute values common to all humankind. Well, you'll notice that the UN has its own version of the commandments in place, and anybody can go on the website and see them. He goes on about the fact that we must create a new religion which is based on my words, but it's from the book. It's the reading between the lines. Earth worship takes you into a controlled society, just like family planning, only it's global planning. And worshipping the earth, you have a dumbed-down population who probably can't read or write down the future. And they'll be given a religion where they'll either have themselves voluntarily sterilized to save Mother Earth, of course, and to make sure there's no mouths that are surplus, that need feeding. And, of course, to so that the elite won't have to bother with the ramifications of discontented, starving people. So yes, this is the same agenda. Michael Gorbachev, with his presidio down in the States there, where he runs this green movement from. It's all part of the Maurice Strong's movement, and Maurice, of course, was picked by the Rockefellers, who are part of the same version of the Fabian Society of London, the intermixed with the Royal Institute of International Affairs. The American branch is the Council on Foreign Relations, and we are being managed just like animals, and they're breeding us up, breeding us down, dumbing us down for sure at the moment, and they intend to cull us down to a manageable size and then clone different types for specific functions in the near future. That way they won't need the media, sports to entertain us, and then we won't be wasteful of all the toys which we reward ourselves, all these little cheap things from China which don't last very long. This is the basic system which is running our world, and you and I and the public have absolutely no say in this agenda whatsoever. All the words of H.G. Wells, which provide the thematic underpinning of this theocracy. At first, the realization of the ineffectiveness of her best thought and knowledge struck only a few people, like Mr. Maynard Keynes, for example. It is science and not men of science that we want to enlighten and animate our politics and rule the world. This was quoted in Mind Control, World Control, pages 306 to 307, 1997. The author was Keith K. E.I.T.H. So there's a member of the Fabian Society giving you their goal, of course, which is rule the world. They want world control. They always did. And the reality is they always had world control. They were just updating their system to ensure that they kept control as they brought the sheep from one pasture to the next pasture for the next stage. And that's where we are now.